What's up guys, I'm PhoenixMaster1 and welcome back to my banner review series. In this series, I review a banner and analyze the new units released in the game and tell you if it's worth summoning on or not. Today we got Farfetch Heroes banner, which contains Lute, Mia and Dorcas. Let's begin with Lute. So she's a blue mage with pretty good offensive stats and a very high res. Her HP is pathetic, so she cannot really take too many hits, and her defense is also really low. She has got a base speed of 32, which is average, but due to the permanent plus 3 bonus she gets from her legendary tome, things get better for her. Her base attack is 36, which is same as Mei and Delphia, so she can hit pretty hard. Her weapon is Wielding Tome, which is a legendary weapon, so it cannot be inherited to any other unit, and it has got speed plus 3 skill built into it, as well as speed ploy, which is amazing because without the plus 3 speed bonus, she just has an average speed stat like I mentioned. So the plus 3 speed from her weapon really helps her a lot. Speed ploy is really good with her high res and helps her double a good amount of units after the debuff or just avoid getting doubled by a lot of the fast mages. Due to her inbuilt speed ploy, I think that plus speed boon is better for her compared to plus attack boon. And her assist skill is rally attack and res, which is always good for more arena points as it is a version 2 rally skill and has got more SP cost. Her slot A skill is HP res 2, which is not really a very good option for an offensive unit like her, and something like Fury is just much better for her. This skill can be used for budget sets as it does improve her low HP stat and gives her more res so that she can ploy more enemies with higher res, but once again, it's not very good, so if you want to build her properly, then you should go with something like Fury. Her slot C skill is res ploy, so she can pretty much debuff 3 stats of enemies with attack ploy sacred seal, similar to Arvis, and she can provide a lot of utility to your team and also hit very hard with her high base attack. For skill inheritance, you should run Fury or Swift Sparrow and Desperation, and she will be fantastic. You should not run Life and Death on her at all as it will reduce her res, which means that she will not be able to proc her ploy skills that much. Fury is her best slotty skill as it gives her more offensive power and more res so that she can proc her ploys against the enemies. She can also run a Blade Tome, but it's not really worth it because she loses out on 3 speed points from her legendary weapon, which is pretty huge, so she functions best with her legendary tome. It's also worth noting that Fury Lute can destroy a plus 10 merged Reinhardt who has got Harsh Summon buffs with Deflect Magic Sacred Seal and then 1 round KO him in that same combat, which is pretty good. Overall, Lute is a solid high tier blue mage and I would consider her to be the 4th best blue mage in the game after Reinhardt, Lind and Delphia. Reinhardt is of course the best blue mage and Lind's offensive spread is much better compared to Lute's, and Delphia has got Dark Aura which provides superior and consistent utility than her ploys. In few days, Lind will also have access to Dark Aura Tome with weapon upgrade feature, so due to all this I find Lute to be a high tier blue mage, but she is still solid at what she does. Now let's move on to the man who got poisoned. Dorcas is the best unit from this banner. He's got a high base attack stat of 35 and a solid defense and HP stat, which makes him a great frontline unit, and he also has average res, so he can make great use of his disencounter weapon. Dorcas is a great enemy phase tank because of his stats and can deal great amount of damage. He's the first axe unit in the game with disencounter built into his weapon, and he actually has average res, so like I said, he can make great use of his disencounter weapon and easily tank hits from mages, and he can of course easily tank hits from Reinhardt with a distant defense sacred seal or HP plus 5 sacred seal. His weapon is legendary, so it is not going to be inheritable to any other unit, and his special is Draconic Aura, which is good with his high attack stat, but Bonfire is a bit better as he gets 17 points of additional damage when he triggers that special. Fierce Stance is just an amazing skill for an enemy phase unit like Dorcas, and honestly it's such a great skill to inherit on a lot of the armored units and the enemy phase units who would love to have attack in the enemy phase, and they no longer have to depend on fire boost for getting attack in the enemy phase, and it was a pretty inconsistent skill because of its HP threshold condition, and Fierce Stance is just much better. Quick Riposte 3 is perfect with a slow tanky unit like him, and Infantry Pulse makes him a good support unit because he has got base HP of 45, which can be boosted to 50 with HP plus 5 Sacred Seal, so he can make great use of Infantry Pulse. His base kit is really good and all you need to do is give him reposition or swap and he will be good to go, but if you want to invest into him more, then you can also run Steady Breath with Aether on him, and it's pretty expensive skill set but it works really well with him. Dorcas is one of the best users of Steady Breath with his good bulk and attack and also the access to a distant counter weapon, and Aether helps him stay in the Quick Riposte and the Infantry Pulse range. Dorcas is a top tier unit in my opinion, but not really as good as Hector or Brave Eye. Hector's Armaz, which has got Corker Post built into it, frees up his slot B skill, and yes, Dorcas does have an open slot A skill compared to Hector, but Hector can abuse Quicker Post plus Vantage, which is just too good, and not to mention Hector also has got access to armor buffs, which is just a bonus. Hector has got a very high HP stat, and due to it, Hector still has slightly more magical bulk compared to Dorcas, so Hector is still better than him in my opinion. It's just that Dorcas can do more damage in the enemy phase and has got better mobility by default, whereas Hector can abuse ridiculous combo of Quick Riposte and Vantage, or even Wings of Mercy if you want to, and still have pretty much the same magical bulk as Dorcas. Armaz freeing up slot B is just huge, but still Dorcas is one of the best Axe units in the game and a top-notch frontline unit. At last, we have got Mia from this banner. She's a sword unit and her stats are absolutely fantastic for an offensive sword unit. She's got good bulk with decent defense and average res. Her weapon is Resolute Blade and gives her plus 3 attack and functions as a vote out plus, but it is not inheritable to any other unit. Luna is her special, which is pretty decent, but with a vote out plus weapon, Moonbow is just much better due to its lower cooldown. Flashing Blade is the speed variant of Heavy Blade, and it's much better than Heavy Blade actually at what it does. However, it is restricted to only melee infantry units and armored units. The good thing is that Phantom Speed Sacred Seal works with it, so it makes its activation much easier than Heavy Blade. Mia can of course abuse this to the max as she's got the high speed stat in the game. Vantage does not go well with her default kit and Desperation is just much better, but I'm assuming that they just have put Vantage on her default kit as a reference, similar to how Deidre has got Ardent Sacrifice as a reference to her own game. And Vantage works good with Distant Counter, but if you're gonna be running Flashing Blade, then Desperation is their best slot B skill. For Skinner Dance, like I said, Moonbow can be run and Desperation is good, and Distant Counter Vantage is also an option which can be run on her, but it's very high investment. Mia is a solid sword unit with a very strong player phase, but ultimately Ira outclasses her due to having Flashing Blade skill built into her weapon, Regnal Astra special, better HP and defense stat. Ira has her slotty skill slot free, so she can either run Distant Counter or Swift Sparrow, but Mia has got Flashing Blade 3 in her slot A. Ira having that built-in skill into her weapon is just much better than having plus and damage whenever you trigger specials, just like Mia. Mia does have better res than Ira, but Ira has got more HP, so in the end, both of them have got pretty much the same magical bulk. Ira can abuse Distant Counter and Aether pretty easily with her weapon, but if Mia runs Distant Counter, then she loses out on the fast charges, so that's why for those reasons I think Ira is still better. However, if you do not have Ira or a good IV Ira, then Mia is pretty nice due to her similarities with Ira. Now I will give you guys my final verdict on this banner. I give this banner a rating of 9 out of 10. This banner continues the trend of good banners which we have got for the past few months, and the best unit from this banner is Dorcas, followed by Mia and at last Lute. All of these are good units, but as you guys would have noticed so far, I have compared these units pretty hard to the previous units, and that is to convey the message that these units are not game breaking by any means. We obviously have got better units than these in the past, and we are actually gonna be getting them in this month as well, through the Legendary Hero banner, which has got 8% focused summon rate and no pity breakers. So any kind of 5-star unit you will summon on this banner will be a focused unit. 8% chance of a focused unit is just ridiculous. This banner has got Ira and Hector, who I have talked about in this video. And don't get me wrong, these new units are solid, no doubt about that, but you should save your orbs for the Legendary Hero banner, and after you've got the units from that banner, you should move on to this banner. I know that these units are fan favorites, but still we will have few more days after the Legendary Hero summon banner, so you will have more days to summon on this banner after it. Once again, these units are very good and solid, but they are not game breaking. Legendary Hero summon banner is filled with top tier units and even some limited time units, so it's absolutely worth saving your orbs few days until that banner, and it's gonna be the best banner in the game so far, so please do consider about that. Also, a lot of you guys have wanted to hear about my opinion on the new update that's going to be released this month, so here it is. I'm actually really excited for the new update. Buffing staff units is definitely a step in the right direction, and as I've said in my collab video with Gas, I would like a Dazzling Staff Sacred Seal, as staff units don't really have enough bulk to safely initiate combat with other units, even with their improved weapons. The cooldown reduction of some of these specials is really good actually and makes these AoE specials more viable with other skills like Infantry Pulse, Quicken Pulse, and Killer Weapons. Glimmer being a 2-turn cooldown special is good for Blade 2 minutes, and a lot of people are saying that it is going to be better than Moonbow. But I do not really think that. Moonbow is still the better 2-turn cooldown special as you get to do more damage against higher defense and res enemies, which is not the case at all with Glimmer because you actually need to do more damage in the first place to make good use of Glimmer. Glimmer is only really useful on Blade 2 minutes because of their insane damage output. Both skills are inconsistent and vary depending on the circumstance of an individual combat, but Moonbow is still more reliable, especially in the losing matchups for your units. Weapon Refinery adds more depth to the game, which is something I really like, and it also upgrades some of the legendary weapons, which really needed some upgrades, like Seliph's Tearfang, Jafar's Deadly Dagger, Aliwood's Durandal, and Merrick's Excalibur. Some units like Lind actually become even better with this feature, as Lind can now completely outclass Delthea with a Dark Aura Tome due to her superior offensive stats compared to Delthea, and Julia can also stand up to her mother with Divine Naga Tome, and in general become a better unit than Deidre as Julia has got more nuking potential and performs much better in the enemy phase because of her higher attack stat. Merrick has got an abysmal attack stat, so he appreciates the Dark Excalibur as he does have decent speed to abuse it. A low tier unit like Seliph can potentially become a high tier unit with Divine Tearfang buff, which is really exciting, and we still do not know about some of the weapon upgrades like Autclair and Soul Catty, which I'm really curious about. They also left out some of the legendary weapons like Roy's Binding Blade and Zephiel's X-Axe, which Intelligent Systems have screwed up in the past, so hopefully they can eventually do something about that. A lot of lesser used weapons like Killer Weapons, Wolf Tomes, Assassin's Bow, Armor Sling weapons can also be upgraded, which sounds promising. Upgrading Killer Weapons and Wolf Tomes just sounds amazing actually. New story mode means that more orbs and more content, which is always good, and we might get a better story this time, and overall this Faye livestream just blew back my expectations. Also, Fjorm is gonna be a free to play unit who can also be summoned on the Legendary Hero Fest banner, and that's gonna be really good as she's got Disencounter weapon and an exclusive defensive special from the looks of it, so she's gonna be a pretty nice addition to the free to play units and could be used a lot in the Grand Hero battles and Bound Hero battles. In the upcoming updates, I would like them to do some kind of upgrade to the dagger units, maybe give them exclusive skills or something like that to just make them better units. Right now we only have a handful of dagger units who are actually useful. I was really expecting Micaiah, but I guess we're gonna be getting her in 2018 by the looks of things, because Intelligent Systems don't really want to touch Radiant Dawn just yet, I guess, and even Thracia 776. So that is gonna be it for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, then please be sure to leave a like, and do not forget to subscribe for more Fire Emblem Heroes content. And with that being said, I'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.